These days, we're getting a lot of games that aren't just your typical hack and slash or platformers. Gris, Journey, Gone Home. These are just some of these games. And now Vane from some of the people behind The Last Guardian, more specifically from the art department. Now these games are more like art or about discovering the true meaning of the story. Normally it's quite a deep story, if it even has a true official meaning, because in my opinion most of these games, or at least a lot of these games, are based more around a more personal experience and a personal conclusion to the story. But after all this, it's still a game, so let's review it like a game. As far as the gameplay, these games tend to keep it on the simple side, and Vane is not much different. There are no enemies, you can't die, and you generally just use 3 or 4 buttons. In Vane's case, there are a few more mechanics since most of these games, since you go through the game transforming in between a bird and a child, each with their own mechanics, though technically the bird just goes faster or slower through its huge vast world. Now, I really like open empty worlds, obviously empty depending on what kind of game we're playing. When it's just a vast world in this type of game, I actually find it quite relaxing. And when you're the bird, it is kind of at a good pace. You can travel a pretty big distance in little time because you're flying as a bird, and you can go around looking at everything at a decent speed. And it's okay because you will have to travel some distance if you do want to clear the platinum trophy. However, the general pace with the child is just a tiny bit too slow for me. Like, it reminds me of Ico, like the movement of Ico when you're the child is like exactly the same. But Ico wasn't in a open kind of empty world. I mean, it was a more compact, puzzly kind of world, and it made sense to go at that pace. And though the child's gameplay isn't generally in the open desert, there is one specific chapter, without spoiling anything since this game is like 2 to 3 hours long, without spoiling anything, there is one chapter with the child that I just found way too repetitive and slow for the pace of the child. And that's without counting the 10-minute walk across the desert as the child if you do want to get the optional trophies for the platinum. Just a little bit slow for me as the child. The bird is fine though, in my opinion. Apart from that, the only thing I can really say about the gameplay is that there are more puzzles in this game than other games of this type, and you know, these games don't normally have a strong gameplay aspect to it, so that's always a nice added bonus. As far as glitches and bugs, I did fall through the floor a few times, or I got stuck on kind of halfway through the floor wall. But there is one specific part of this game where you use a certain mechanic to change the environment, and I think the game kind of tried to do a bit too much and a bit too over the top, and that's what caused these bugs. But you can just press a button and kind of reset it, so it's not too bad. As far as the art style, I really like it. It's unique in the way that it changes around you at certain points of the game. And the graphics are kind of unique, and like I said, there are some of the people from behind The Last Guardian in this part of the design. And you know, the visuals are one of the most important things behind these type of art or experience type of games, so well done for that. Audio is also very important in this type of game, and they have done an absolutely amazing job, but doing it with sounds that you wouldn't really expect, like the instruments or just the sound effects used in the soundtrack of this game are actually kind of unique, and it's like a soundtrack you wouldn't expect, but it actually works really, really well. And that leaves us with the story, and I'm not going to tell you what I think the story is about, but I think that just like most of these emotional arty type games, it's a lot deeper than that, and I think it's more of a personal experience. I'm not trying to say that there is no official base to the story, but I think for each one of us it goes deeper, and for me that's what really counts in this type of game, or should I say experience. For me, Vane gets a 7.5 out of 10, and anybody that enjoyed Journey, Gris, or even games like Ico should definitely go and pick this up. Vane is now available on PS4 for about $25. Thanks for watching, guys. Hopefully this review was helpful. If it was, please go like and subscribe. Remember, you can support the channel more directly by clicking the join button down below. I'll see you next time, guys.